The Pennsylvania State Museum is celebrating 50 years since the opening of their distinctive drum-shaped building in downtown Harrisburg. For most of those 50 years, one of the most popular exhibits has been Mammal Hall. Staff members sometimes refer to it as the Mona Lisa of the museum. 13 full-sized dioramas are displayed along the curving walls of the hall, each artistically lit in the dim room, each featuring a different mammal native to Pennsylvania, from the red fox, the gray wolf, bears, and bearcats, to the imposing bison. Staring out across the centuries from atop a snowy mound, the dioramas are a combination of science, art, natural history, and theater. But after 50 years, a lot of dust has collected and colors have faded, and the mammals in the hall are in need of a facelift of sorts. To restore the exhibit, the museum has turned to Stephen C. Quinn, the man who literally wrote the book on museum dioramas. He is both an artist and a naturalist, and for years he oversaw every aspect of the development of dioramas at the American Museum of Natural History in Manhattan.
The dioramas are a unique combination of both art and science. They provide and facilitate this one-on-one encounter with wildlife that's very different from film or computer interactives. They really do incorporate art techniques and methods to facilitate the creation of nature. The dioramas are the end result of both artists and scientists going into the field, collecting specimens and data with the intent of recreating that specific site back here at the museum.
50 years ago, artists and naturalists made field trips to locations around Pennsylvania and brought back photographs, drawings, color notes, and detailed studies of plant life. They created models and sketches of how the dioramas would be displayed and constructed Mammal Hall with meticulous attention to detail.
Over 50 years, the pigments have faded on many of the specimens. So the taxidermist working on the project will be airbrushing the color back onto the animals with archival dyes.
And these specimens here have been recolored. Before they were this very bleached out buff color, and now we've restored all the warm tones to them. Museum taxidermy is a wonderful art form because it really allows the visitor to see an animal that they might not have the opportunity to see up close. And it allows you to inspect the animal closely, look at the texture of the hair, look at the shape of the eyes, and study it a little bit more closely than you would normally be able to in the wild.
He might be at a slightly different angle, but you see off his eye there, just I would angle the box turtle, it just sits on the ground.
I came in here on this project as kind of this all-around artist to enhance the scene, the foreground as well as the background painting, make it merge together, come back to life, merging 2D and 3D. It's a totally different art form than anything else.
The thing that makes these dioramas so unique is they depict actual sites and real locations across the state of Pennsylvania.
The background painting was done by John Cusera, and what we wanted to do is visit the site, which is in Newburytown in York County, not too far from here, and really see what he was seeing in perspective on the site, get a good idea of the landscape, the foreground elements, the trees, and we learned a lot. There's actually a house depicted in this scene. The house is still there. And we realized when we got there that the artist kept a very true feeling of a Pennsylvania farmland.
Two of the diorama restorations have been completed, and the rest are expected to be done by the end of 2016.
I think once the visitor sees these for the first time, they'll notice that everything should be richer, cleaner, more vibrant. I think they'll be able to sense that there's a more luminescent look to everything. Everything looks warmer and richer.
It's hoped that we, through our work, will spark the interest in young people especially to facilitate a lifelong interest in nature.
So for at least another 50 years, Mammal Hall is likely to continue to be the Mona Lisa of the State Museum of Pennsylvania. For the WITF Arts and Culture Desk, I'm Kerry Burkett.